Well, it's February 2nd, and today we had three majors come out on the Kaylee Anthony murder trial or case. And we had not only People magazine, but we had the Globe and the Inquirer come out. And though the People magazine is quite good, and you'll probably want to pick it up just so that you can have once again a consolidation of the information that we have been talking about for some time. I want to read you, here is, I know the printing is backwards, but that's the way it happens here. But the title of the article is Dad's Confession, Casey Did It. The Secret Behind His Suicide Attempt. Well, these are all teaser, of course, headlines. And remember, the dad's confession is a confession is when you do it. You can't confess for somebody else. A confession is only of use to help, you know, the opinion is, when it's someone else, it's an opinion. You can't confess for Casey. You understand what I'm trying to say. I'm going to read to you a little something now. This is the meat. This is the meat of our research at this point. I'm kicking you out, and I'm keeping Kaylee. Cindy Anthony screamed those furious words as she seized her daughter Casey by the throat during a violent fight the night before police believe Angel Face Kaylee was murdered. The clash is the reason Casey allegedly killed her beautiful two-year-old daughter, a source close to the family told Inquirer during an exclusive interview. Casey was going to be left with nothing, the source explained. Okay, that's well said. Now let's go into this a little bit more here. I can't read the whole thing. Let's see, when they right back when the conflict exploded into violence. Oh, all right. She went to the nursing home, talked to her parents. Her parents told her about the theft, and one more time, Cindy was able to talk her way out of it. She, you know, she bullied her parents as well. They were not exclusive. But when they arrived back home at in Orlando, the conflict exploded. Cindy grabbed Casey by the throat and told her that she was going to take little Kaylee from her. Casey's brother, Lee, arrived at the house in time to break it up, to break up the fight, and he saw his mother with her hands around Casey's throat, said the source. Lee didn't tell the police at first, but now he has told the detectives that he heard his mother screaming, "I'm kicking you out, and I'm keeping Kaylee." Cindy repeated it to Lee. "I'm going to throw her out and take Kaylee away from her." Lee was able to separate the women, said the source. And then we have next morning, June 16th, Cindy woke, left for work before Casey was awake. Now, we have, let's see, I think I wrote it. Be patient with me here. I've got several pages to juggle, and it's not always easy. Okay, make note that little Kaylee was wearing white shorts on Father's Day during that video, okay? Now, in finding little Katie's remains, what the investigators found in the wooded area was a pair of white shorts found with Katie's remains in a wooded area near the family home. Similar to what the child was wearing in the video, setting a timeline for the murder because it means she was killed before she changed into her pajamas for bed. That's a clincher. Her remains were found with the same shorts that are consistent with that video on Father's Day. So these are the major scoops, I think, that these two tabloids have. The rest is, they're still of interest, but this is really pivotal, I think. Let me find something more here. This is People magazine. And it's well written, but I care less about it being well written as providing me with some facts. Okay, here I've got some things underlined. Okay, we're going on to George's quote unquote suicide attempt. When the police arrived at the Hawaii motel, they found George neatly dressed and his room undisturbed. When they saw a note which claimed he had taken a lot of pills, they decided he needed help. In the trash, they found two empty pill bottles with the labels peeled off. George and Cindy are both suffering beyond what you can imagine, lied the family's attorney, Brad Conway. Well, I put that lying thing in there. He also sent several text messages during this time, including to Cindy, apparently. Now, as of January 26th, he remained in the hospital, though his lawyer says that George had regained his will to live. I think that's touching. Again, there's another mention about Cindy would tell Casey she was immature, and Casey would tell Cindy she was ruining her life. They could not communicate if it wasn't for their fighting and bickering. Meaning, the fighting and bickering was their only way of communicating with one another. Does that not sound a little familiar to you? And in this particular, in the People's magazine article, they went on and said, I watched Cindy berate George over the littlest thing. Just mean, nasty stuff. And she'd say, George, you're so stupid, in front of friends. We're getting close to the end of this, my 10-minute limit here. According to documents, at one point, Cindy wanted to divorce George, but changed her mind because she feared losing the house and her savings in a settlement. The main problem in their marriage seemed to be vastly different personalities. Cindy, who works as a nurse, as the domineering type, she's very type A. She really runs the house. She's the one who earns the money. George sort of defers to her, does whatever she wants, treats her like royalty. Now, okay, I got a few more seconds. During one period when he was unemployed, he sheepishly told investigators he fell prey to an internet scam. He provided, just a minute, gotta go. I got to turn it off.